We are back on Taking Care of Business on Kern Radio, News Talk 1180, for the best in Saturday Talk Radio and 1230 KGEO, 1410 KERI, and now in Albuquerque, New Mexico at 1000 KKIM. Our next guest is a gentleman that Clay and I supported 3 years ago in his run for Congress, 16th senatorial candidate, Andy Vidick. Andy, welcome to Taking Care of Business.
Good morning. Thanks for having me on.
Well, we're glad to have you. What's the reason for running for this office?
Oh, man. Well, you know, Michael Rubio surprised us all when he resigned. And, you know, I was not looking for a race at the moment. Or I was back at the ranches. And, I just leased a ranch in January. You know, I had some plans. I was going to plant some lemons and do some things. But this thing came up. And, boy, it's an open seat. And this state is just an absolute mess. And this Central Valley has just been left behind over and over and over with the current elite liberal leadership. We could go into a lot of different things, but, I mean, the funds are being drained from us. You know, gold was found up around Sacramento 164 years ago, and when those veins played out, they've been mining us ever since. And that's got to stop, and we need a good voice, and that's why I'm doing it.
Well, how do you think that your one voice is going to have an impact up in Sacramento that's got the supermajority, I believe?
Well, we've got a unique district here. The registration is, you know, almost 50% Democrat, but we're going to win this election, and we're going to, and the state and the liberal elite up there are going to find out that we have independent voters, and when we're not treated right, when our promises aren't kept here, and our resources are being taken away from us, that's going to send a shockwave, and that's my goal. You know, I don't ride a white horse. I'm not a magic bullet, but I am going to be the voice of all the people in this district, and I'm excited to do that. I'm willing to talk to anyone up there. I know there will be those with a door locked and want to throw rocks at me, but that's not the way I'm going to do business. I want to be able to try to talk to everyone I can there. And, yeah, they have a supermajority, but we're underrepresented here, and we're not getting the funds that we're supposed to get, and the state's actually running people out of the state. We're 50th now in taxes for small businesses, and you know, we've got some serious budgetary priorities that we've got to tackle, and some of these extra things that they want, bullet trains and $2 million per fish salmon down the San Joaquin River. I mean, from a taxpayer standpoint, it just doesn't make sense. And it doesn't matter what side of the aisle you're on. Well, you don't have clean drinking water in Avenel or Kettleman City or East Orosi, Seville, and yet we're willing to spend billions on a train. It just doesn't make sense.
You know, Andy, I read an article in the Bakersfield Californian recently that said you stand a good chance to win this election on the initial ballot, but if you don't win it on the initial ballot, you probably won't win it. What do you think of that? Those comments or those reviews?
Well, I think we got a heck of a chance winning May 21st. We're working very hard. We're talking to a tremendous amount of voters. We've got a good message, a message that resonates. And you know, if there is a runoff July 23rd, I think we've got just as good of a chance because the message is still there. It's a good message. It's common sense solutions. It's budgetary priorities, and you know, the so-called experts. I mean, the guys in Vegas are wrong all the time too. So I don't know how I think the message in the candidate prevails every time.
Now, are you the only Republican running in this field?
I am the only Republican. Yes, we've got three Democrats and one Peace and Freedom.
Okay, so you're the only Democrat, but it's, like you say, it's, I mean, only Republican. I'm sorry,
yeah.
Only Republican. It's primarily a Democratic district, but I was looking at some statistics the other day, and you polled 17% in that last election greater than the number of Republicans in your district. That's an incredible amount. That's a great statistic.
Well, we have a good message, and I'm willing to go where I would say maybe traditionally some Republicans have feared to go, and I would go where Democrats take the folks for granted. I remember going down to the Dolores Huerta Foundation and doing an event down there for them, and I was the only candidate there besides two guys running for irrigation supervisor. Fran Flores didn't send anybody. Jim Costa didn't send anybody. Michael Rubio sent someone to speak for him. Tim Thiessen didn't send anybody, and David Valdez sent somebody that didn't speak. And so I went, I got there an hour early or a half hour early and met everybody at the door and had my signs up and went through the forum and had dinner with them and helped put the tables away while we were done. And there might have been 33, 40 people there, but about 12, 14 yard signs left that night. So, I mean, we have a good message, and we just have to go out and talk to folks. And this particular election coming up, basically the same type of numbers, except it overlaps only plus or minus, it's 77% overlaps with the same district I ran in last time, basically from Barbaugh down to Arvin-Lamont. But the difference is this time that we have Tulare County, big parts of Tulare County in this district, and not all of it, not Visalia, not Exeter, not Tulare, but Rosie, Woodlake, parts of Dinuba, and I'm fourth generation, both sides of my family in Tulare County. My dad's county superintendent of schools of Tulare County and has been for over 20 years. I had a lot of friends thought in Tulare County they were voting for me, and they're voting for my dad, but that's okay, and this time hopefully they think they're voting for my dad and they're voting for me, or either one, but we've got a very good name there. Yep. And, I farm in Tulare County also.
Good. Our guest by phone, 16th senatorial candidate, Andy Vidick.
You know, Andy, you've got a pretty good competitor in Leticia Perez. She was recently voted in as a county supervisor just a few months ago, and then all of a sudden she decided to run for this seat. And what's your opinion on somebody that would jump ship so quickly? What's her next venture? Is it going to be to go to the Congress or the Senate?
You know, I can't answer for her. You know, she had to move in 2 days prior to the filing deadline into the district because she didn't live in the district. She is leaving some folks high and dry there and that worked very hard for her. I can't speak for a lot, most of those people down there. I try to listen to them, and there's some people upset, and there's some people that are supporting me. There's some people probably supporting other candidates. Her ambitions, I don't know. All I can tell you is that I live in the middle of my district. I don't need a job. I'm not looking to be famous. All I want to do is represent this valley and get our fair share of stuff and stop spending and driving people out. I mean, we've got huge energy resources here that we need to go after. We've been hydraulically fracking in Kern County for over 60 years. Some of the areas, it's over 60% of the wells are done that way. The water's recycled. We haven't had any issues, but yet. When this big find is leaked out into the news, we've got people rushing, knee-jerk reaction in Sacramento, actually trying to stop it. They don't even realize, they don't even know what's going on. They never run a business. They never created jobs. Most of my working life, I worked for other people. I came out of school from Texas Tech. My dream was to have my own farm, my own ranch, and I worked hard for other people. I worked in the fields, planting and harvesting vegetables up and down the valley. Built forklift, worked in cold storages, and ended up in produce sales, and scrimped and saved, and finally bought my own piece of ground. And now I farm both in Kings and Tulare counties. I run a lettuce cooling business in Fresno County. And, when I first decided to run in 2009, it was because I saw folks that were working for me, good friends, standing in a food line in the middle of summer because the water had been cut off like it has been now. And they were being given Chinese carrots, product of China, in cans, in state food lines, in San Joaquin, where people should have been working. And it's just a tragedy. Over and over again, we're left behind here.
Let me follow up on that question I asked about Leticia and ask you a similar question, because you ran for Congress against Jim Costa, and now you're backing down and running for the Senate seat in California. Is this a stepping stone for you to get to Congress?
No, not at all. When they changed the boundaries, I live right in the heart of Hanford, and if I wanted to be a congressman right now, I could. David was really willing to step up and go to Washington, D.C. I had pushed Jim Costa to the north, got him out of Kings County, and when that happened, the bigger hog elbowed the other one away from the trough, and Cardoza had to retire. So I felt that I'd done my civic duty there. I had never dreamed of being a congressman as a young boy. I wanted to be a professional baseball player and a cowboy. And, I didn't make baseball, and I'm not a great cowboy. But I'm very happy with my deal in life here. And, I think my father serves, and anyone who serves, whether it's in a city council, any elected official, city, county, state, federal. It's a big sacrifice, and you are serving. You put up a lot of your time away from your family, away from your businesses, if you have them. And that's what it's all about, trying to help people and trying to make the whole state better, as well as your district. So I have no ambitions of running for Congress. I have no ambitions. I would like to be a state senator for, you know, with the new term limits here. It's always up to the voters. But I have an opportunity to be there for 13 years and get some things done. And
that would be great.
This seat is a big, big part of the giant chessboard. We have an opportunity to take this seat. And honestly, in 2014, a lot of folks say, well, yeah, you probably win this, but can you keep it? Well, we lose a big part of Fresno City in the district next time, and we pick up more of Flutter County. We pick up more of Porterville and more of the rural communities where we do very, very well. And that's going to be to my benefit. Plus,
sure.
I'm going to be out there working the district. I mean, that's my job, is go out and help people.
Andy, let's hold on to that thought. We'll pick it up in a moment, okay? We'll be back in a moment on Taking Care of Business on Kern Radio News Talk 1180.